This is a bowl of glue. It's not very interesting. But if you add a few ingredients and give it a mix, it will turn into slime. And with one more ingredient, you can turn this slime into magnetic slime. Whoa! But what's the best recipe for magnetic slime? Let's find out by making some at home, including this slime that can glow in the dark. Awesome! Are you ready? Then let's get scienced. To make magnetic slime at home, you'll need Elmer's glue, water, bicarb soda, food coloring, contact lens solution, iron filings, a bowl, and some measuring cups and spoons. Start by adding a third of a cup of glue, 1.5 tablespoons of water, 1/2 teaspoon of bicarb soda, and 8 drops of food coloring to a bowl. Then stir these ingredients together until they're mixed well. Next, add 1 tablespoon of contact lens solution to the bowl and start stirring. After a few seconds, you'll notice the mixture turning into slime. Keep mixing for a few more seconds until it looks like this. Then remove the spoon and mix the slime with your hands. At this stage, it might stick to your fingers. But after mixing it for a minute, you'll have a ball of slime that's no longer sticky. This slime can bounce, stretch, ooze, and snap. Now that we've made our slime, let's turn it into magnetic slime. To do this, wear a mask and ask an adult to add 2 tablespoons of iron filings to the slime. Carefully fold the slime over itself and then over itself again, and keep going until all of the iron is mixed through. And that's it. You've just made magnetic slime. This slime will move a little bit when placed next to an ordinary magnet, but it will move a lot when placed next to a neodymium magnet. Okay, let's quickly pause for a safety message. These magnets are super strong and dangerous if swallowed. For this reason, only an adult should use them. You should also keep these magnets away from electronic devices, particularly pacemakers. And also be careful around magnetic substances, as these magnets will attract them and your fingers might get pinched if they get in the way. If you're not sure about using them, you can just watch these clips. This is a time lapse of the slime swallowing a magnet. Awesome! And this is me stretching the slime using a magnet. How cool does that look? We've made slime, we've made magnetic slime. It's now time to make magnetic slime that glows in the dark. To do this, you'll need to buy some glow-in-the-dark powder. Add 1 tablespoon of this powder to the slime and fold the slime over until it's all mixed together. Then add 1 tablespoon of the powder and fold the slime over itself. At this point, it was getting pretty thick, so I added 1 tablespoon of water. Shine a torch at the slime and then turn the torch off to watch it glow. Whoa! This is what it looks like when you stretch it. And this is what it looks like swallowing a magnet. How cool does that look? So how did I come up with this recipe for magnetic slime? I started by making 9 different samples of slime. Each one had a different amount of glue, water, and contact lens solution. Slime samples 1, 4, and 7 were too sticky. They didn't have enough contact lens solution, so they were eliminated. I then put the remaining slime samples through their first test, which I like to call the ooze test. I got a paper cup and carefully cut out a 2.5 centimeter hole from the bottom. I then used my stand to hold the cup 30 centimeters above the table. While holding a small piece of paper over the base of the cup, I added my first slime sample and waited 1 minute for it to settle in the cup. After a minute, I let go of the paper and timed how long it took the slime to reach the table. Slime samples 2 and 3 took the longest to reach the table. They were too thick and not oozy enough, so they were eliminated. I now only had 4 slime samples remaining, and so I needed 1 more test. This one was simple. See how well they hold their shape. I know they all have a good amount of ooze, but I also want a slime that can hold its shape nicely. Slime samples 8 and 9 didn't hold their shape very well, so they were eliminated. Slime samples 5 and 6 were about the same when it came to holding their shape. So seeing as slime sample 5 had a quicker time on the ooze test, it was declared the winner. Having found my favorite recipe for making slime, I now needed to test two different ways of making it magnetic, adding iron filings and adding iron oxide. Both of these can be bought online. Just make sure you buy iron filings that are fine rather than coarse. The fine ones are a lot smaller and so better to handle compared to the larger ones, which could get stuck in your skin like a splinter. I ended up making four different samples of magnetic slime. Two had different amounts of iron filings and two had different amounts of iron oxide. It was now time for the final test, seeing how quickly the magnetic slime could swallow a magnet. For this test, I placed the magnet in front of each slime. I started timing as soon as the magnet touched the slime and stopped as soon as the magnet disappeared. Sample 2 was the quickest, taking only 3 seconds to swallow the magnet. So it was the winner. And that's how I chose this recipe for my magnetic slime. If you leave this slime for a few days, it will start to turn brown. That's just the iron rusting. But it might also lose its stretchiness. If this happens, just make another batch. The slime samples made with iron oxide didn't turn brown and also stayed pretty stretchy. So if you don't mind them being a little bit slower swallowing the magnets, they're also good options. A huge thanks to Maya for suggesting this video. If you'd like to see a particular science experiment or activity on this channel, send me a message on Instagram or Facebook or email me at sillyscienceWithSimon@gmail.com. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time on Silly Science with Simon.